Hello, and welcome to Kirk's Town Tours. You must have woken up on the right side of the bed this morning, because today is your lucky day. You'll be getting some premium tour action from the boss man himself. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I'm Kirk. Together with the Stars Hollow Board of Tourism, we created these tours as a way to show the rest of the world what this town is all about. In addition to getting to know the geographical lay of the land, I'm hoping you'll also come away knowing a little about the good people of this town. We have a well-deserved reputation for being full of colorful characters. It's tough for an average guy like myself to stand out in a place like this, and I'm hoping that today you'll get a chance to meet a few of these characters. I'll do my best to give you the most thorough overview and illuminating insight into this town that I possibly can, but if you'd like to know more, feel free to stop in at the Kirkstown Tour shop on your way out to pick up the History of Stars Hollow Guidebook, an extensive publication that details, with colorful as well as historical pictures, this town. These tours have been very popular, however, so if that item's not available, there are a number of much more modestly priced, great souvenir gift items like t-shirts and mouse pads. But for now, let's begin our excursion through my hometown, Stars Hollow. This is the house of Lorelai Gilmore, Stars Hollow's local innkeeper. She is one of our town's most spirited entrepreneurs. If you check into the Dragonfly Inn, you'll probably have the pleasure of meeting her. Tell her Kirk of Kirkstown Tours sent you, and she may give you the Super Kirkstown Tour discount. Or she may deny that the Super Kirkstown Tour discount exists. In either case, make sure Michelle, the inn's concierge, isn't around, as these coupons tend to make him a little more French than usual. But back to the tour. This is Lorelai's home sweet home. Previous residents included another Lorelai Gilmore, better known to us locals as Rory. She's now completing her senior year at Yale University. In fact, 4 years ago, it was I who had the pleasure, civic pride, and business savvy to announce Rory's admittance to Yale by means of this unisexually flattering 100% cotton t-shirt. Sadly, the Stars Hollow Business Owners Association, of which I'm merely the undersecretary, nixed the idea of matching jogging pants, but that's another story entirely. Lorelai, who much to her own detriment is not on the SHBOA, as I like to call it, currently lives with Paul Anka. Not the sharply dressed world-class entertainer of puppy love notoriety, but an actual puppy who, despite sharing the same name, is a second-rate singer at best. While the Lorelais and dog Paul Anka live here, I myself am no stranger to this residence. I've been a friend, neighbor, DSL installer, wedding photographer, mechanic, exterminator, security professional, and United States mail carrier. I like to think if not for my contributions to this property, well, it might not even be here.
Well, I checked under the entire house.
And?
You have termites.
What?
Tens of thousands of them. Subterranean, dry wood, the whole gamut.
Gross.
Four of them crawled up my nose.
What can we do right now? The alarm is just so loud.
Yeah, that's my fault too. I asked Jimmy to really crank it up.
Well, he did.
If you're gonna have an alarm, you need it loud. You don't want some crazed knife-wielding gunman at your throat and the neighbors are going like, is that a fan? Did I leave the water running? You want them to know, hey, that's an alarm.
Your imaginary attacker has a knife and a gun?
And a really dirty tank top.
Okay.
I was also instrumental in delivering one of the biggest pieces of news to this house. Though, between you and me, these girls drink way too much coffee.
Kirk! Kirk!
Good morning, ladies.
Is there an envelope in there?
A big envelope, not a little envelope.
Yeah, big envelope means she's in, little envelope means she needs to marry Rich.
Just one second, please.
Aren't you supposed to go through the mail before you get here?
Some work that way. Personally, I think it takes the spontaneity out of the job.
Need some help?
Sorry, federal law prohibits it.
Any chance you could go faster?
Yeah, you got a girl's future in that sack of yours, Santa.
Thank you for adding the Santa.
Anytime.
You know, over the years, I've invested so much of my time and considerable know-how into this house that it almost feels like home to me. In fact, for a short while, it was. Though, Lorelai's a lot stricter than my mom. And a lot hotter.
Kirk, is the TV still on?
Oh, I forgot.
No, I'll get it. You'd forget your head if it wasn't screwed on.
Don't deny that you're on the phone.
Phone's in the living room.
What are you guys talking about? Fine.
No forts.
This concludes our tour of Lorelai's house. If you'll follow me in an orderly fashion, we'll move on to our next destination. Please be careful not to disturb Babette's gnomes as you cross the lawn. And don't look at them directly either. They don't like that at all.